You're late.
Couldn't call my ride.
Hey! Let's hear it for Captain America!
Welcome! Well, I've got a Funko Pop unboxing for you today that is a really special one. I know I've said that before, but come on, you can trust me. When I say that a Funko Pop is pretty spectacular, I'm usually bang on the money, admit it. And this one, I know there's going to be a lot of you who really like this. There's some of you who've got this. This is something I saw Leroy Screwballs unbox. It must have been about 18 months ago, maybe even a bit more. I always liked the look of the Pop and thought, even though that's a line I've got no interest in, I would quite like that. I just liked how it looked. I also believe Scarlett at Albatross Pops has got this. Coomsey might have it as well. Those of you who also have this, let me know in the comments, as it's a pretty pricey thing, £65 from Killer Pops. So this is instantly one of the higher priced Funko Pops I've added to my collection. And for something that up until very recently, I wasn't even a fan of, that's quite a lot to pay. So thank you to Killer Pops for sending this out pretty promptly. And of course, thank you to the tool that allows me to get boxes open with relative ease here on YouTube, the trusty yellow knife. If it hadn't been for Card and I, Joe, I'd have been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Card and I, Joe? If it hadn't been for Card and I, Joe, I'd have been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Card and I, Joe? All right, and now let us have a Sizzle! Woo! I'm so excited to add this to my collection. It's only the second Pop ever in this line I've ever had. I'll explain as I get it open why I've suddenly got it. Killer Pops, I've used them a few times now. Fantastic packaging as always. Quite a big box just for one Pop. But it does look like it's coming a sorter. Quite a lot of bubble wrap falling out of the box there, but that's fine. I'd rather be too much than not enough. Smells a little bit of tobacco. The lady who is Killer Pops, Katie, I think, whether she or someone who works for her is a smoker, it doesn't bother me. Perhaps I'm wrong, perhaps it's just the sort of bubble wrap they use as a sort of tobacco-y kind of smell. Just thought I'd bring that up. I have noticed it before with previous Killer Pops orders, but it's no big deal as far as I'm concerned. So need another slizzle here as this sorter, if you can call it a sorter, it's maybe a bit big to be technically a sorter box, but this is sealed as well. But yeah, this is quite an expensive purchase. I don't want to use the G word because I wouldn't class it as that, but I know that it's going to be instantly one of my favourite Pops in my entire collection because I loved it ever since I saw it on Leroy Screwball's channel a long time ago. And since very recently, which I'll talk about in a minute, I knew I wanted it. Oh yeah. Brilliant packaging. It's come bubble wrapped yet again inside this second box. And I believe it's come in a protector as well, which is fantastic. Ah. Let me get out of the protector right from the get-go. What type of protector is this? Not sure. Like a generic one, but feels pretty sturdy. Always happy to get a free protector. An indulgence, this. But I think you'll agree, this is an absolutely amazing looking Pop. I've got number 219 in the Marvel Captain America the First Avenger line. It is Captain America in his World War II attire. and it is a 2017 Spring Convention exclusive. Now then, this will technically be pre-owned, I think. You know what? This box is in great condition. I was talking about this very same purchase with Wayne Deacon, shout out to his lordship.
Have you farted?
On Facebook a few days ago, and he reckoned there was bad damage to this. There isn't, Wayne. Take my word for it. In fact, you don't even need to take my word for it, just look. Looks great. I think the only thing that Killer Pops made reference to in the listing was that the sticker slightly overhangs, look. That doesn't bother me. It's gone back in a protector anyway. Doesn't matter at all, to be honest. But fantastic. So, why did I get this? What with it being the third lockdown? Is it the third? Yeah, it will be. And having a bit more time on my hands, and just in between my usual things of spending time with my family, shooting YouTube videos, I've had some extra time to kill, and I've started watching the Marvel Cinematic movies in the timeline order, or the order that's suggested on Disney Plus, anyway. And the very first movie out of that whole timeline was Captain America, the First Avenger. And you know what? Still, and I've watched quite a lot of them now, I think I'm up to... I've just watched Captain America Civil War, which was great. So I think it's Black Panther next, if the Disney Plus order is correct. Captain America First Avenger is still my favourite. And I knew that the pop, the World War II Captain America or Steve Rogers, was from that particular film. Loved that film. Really sort of made me want to see the rest of the MCU. This is only the second Marvel pop I've ever got after the Venom one that I unboxed last year. But I've always thought this was a beautiful pop, even though I had no interest in Captain America or Marvel itself back then. But at least I have now seen the film. I'm a fan of the film. Someone said to me yesterday, you ought to do a video where you rank the MCU films after you've watched them all. And presumably WandaVision, the series as well. I will get that watched at some point after I've done with the films. And I might do that, I'll see. If people want me to do something like that, let me know. But I don't think I'll be able to go into great detail over all the movies in the MCU. I'll just be sort of ranking them and saying, yeah, this is number 15 or 14, you know. But as I say, despite Deacon's protestations, this is in fantastic condition. I will get him out. I mean, he's going straight back in a pop protector, a pop this price, and it would be an inbox pop for me anyway. I've got to keep it in box and keep it safe. So, this being Marvel, I mean, of course, this is only my second ever bobblehead pop. That's still like a gimmick, a new thing for me, even though most of my friends and peers here on YouTube, they unbox Marvel and Star Wars, which are always bobbleheads all the time, so this is nothing new. But for me, this is a bit of an unusual but fun gimmick, this. Check him out. I mean, he's got a blue helmet on, goggles on the top. I mean, he just evokes that sort of 1930s, 1940s look instantly. And I like the character. I like his backstory, Steve Rogers. I like the actor who played him, Chris Evans. I think he did a smashing job. So I'm absolutely made up to have got this. This is such a great pop. Quite pricey, but Killer Pops' price was way cheaper than what I could find it on eBay. He's got like a sort of brown, what would you call that, trench coat. Oh, I like the sort of detail we've got here where there's rips in it. Of course, he's carrying an American flag shield, utility belt type thing around his waist. The sort of brown trousers with like khaki green bits on them. Brown boots, gloves. I like how the straps for his helmet aren't fastened. They just sort of hang down sort of in front of his ears almost. I love it. Instantly, one of the best pops that I've picked up in quite some time, this. Fantastic. My last Funko Pop unboxing, I did it. And then I sort of sat for a couple of days looking at some of those pops, the Coke can, the Coke bottle top, the spam can, and I thought, I don't like this line. And that's me, I love sort of product-related stuff and advertising stuff, but I just thought, Funko, that's a step too far. It's a cash grab, and I'm not going to start ranting about that in a video that's got nothing to do with it, but this, I know. I mean, I want to keep him out of box for a little while just to enjoy him how he should look, but I will put him back in his box. I want to keep him nice. But there we are, World War II. Captain America or Steve Rogers from the First Avenger movie. As I say, I'm watching all the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies for the very first time at the moment. There's not been one that I've absolutely disliked. There's been one or two that I've thought were maybe average or above average. But fortunately, I'm enjoying the series overall a lot. Some of the films, like I say, the first Avenger is still my favourite one. It happened to be the first one in that timeline as well. That really set me up to really want to go and watch the rest. Enjoying the MCU for the very first time as a newbie. And, well, as soon as I finished watching the first Avenger, I knew I wanted this pop at some point. And I couldn't ignore it for the price it was at Killer Pops for any time longer. Thank you everyone for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this extra special Marvel Funko Pop unboxing. You don't see many of those on the Jimmy Barnes channel, do you? Special thanks, as always, to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. My Patreon link, my Facebook group link, and of course all my Funko affiliate links, including an exclusive 10% off code at Glass Shelf Collectibles. All that good stuff is down in the video description, so don't delay, have a look today. I'm going to go now. I'm going to put Steve Rogers, World War II, back in his pop protector, display him somewhere prominent. Beautiful, beautiful figure. I love it. And I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next Funko Pop unboxing. Cheers, everyone. See ya!
Jason clowmates with tea towels in his kitchen come masturbatorium. He is such a runny bum bum, he's like a 4-foot chocolate fountain. Beardsley and Mrs. Geek love having a threesome with shit ass clow in the sex pool. Cooch this pee 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 pee.
Jimmy, you've got issues, bro.